Tanya Renee Pennington, aka the Beast, Tater Tot, Little Miss Sunshine, or my favorite, Boo. From the very beginning, we knew this was a God thing. God has given me the greatest gift ever, and this gift is you. He took two people from completely two different times in their life and threw them together to make one life. What's amazing is that we are from two different worlds. Your world consists of box jumps, muscle-ups, toes to bar, clean and jerk, overhead squats, handstand push-ups, and my all-time favorite, double-unders. And then there's nutrition, protein, carb, fat, vegetables that I should be following. And then there's Total Nutrition, your supplement store. And I know firsthand that you can get a good tan there because that's how I met you. My world consists of just a couple dirt bikes in the garage. Then there's motos, ruts, tabletops, whoops, berms, double jumps, triple jumps, and these are not with a jump rope. Then there's my riding gear, boots, helmet, and maybe someday you will be able to clean my goggles for me. Oh, yeah, my nutrition. Pizza, a dark stout beer, and a big piece of chocolate cake. Now that's good stuff. What's funny about all this is only God could look at these two worlds and say these people are perfect for each other. Boo, you have become my best friend. You have brought God into my life and love into my heart. You are my true love. You are the last piece to my crazy little puzzle. You complete me. Now in front of God, family and friends, I consider it an honor and a privilege to be the one you have chosen as your life mate. I promise to be a true and faithful husband, to love you, respect you, and be honest with you always. I promise to be supportive of your goals as you grow intellectually, emotionally, spiritually. I will be by your side, rooting for you all the CrossFit way. Never be afraid to confide in me. I promise to be a good listener, a safe confidant. You are always welcome in my innermost world, garage. And I promise to share my goals and ideas with you as we grow together throughout our marriage. There are no limitations on the possibilities of our relationship, and I hope we never realize just how high our high can be. I believe you, Boo, and I will be there for you always. I love you.
Brett, my bear, I never thought a man like you existed, but because of the slight chance that you possibly did, I've been waiting for you for over 30 years. My mom has always told me from a young age that she hoped I would wait until I was in my 30s to get married. And now I believe she had received a message from God all those years ago because he knew he would deliver you to me at the age of 32 and you would become my husband at the age of 34. You contain so many beautiful qualities that I never could have dreamed of asking for in one man. If I had asked and prayed for a man who had all of the qualities that you do, I'm positive I would have been laughed at. I would have been told to lower my expectations and to be more realistic. I would have been told that all of those qualities cannot possibly come in one man. You're my lover and my best friend, all wrapped in one. There will be times that I will fail you. There will be times that I'll fall short, I'll be selfish, and I can promise you that I'll leave my shoes around the house. But I vow to you today that I will never tap out and I will never give up on us. I promise to love you under any and all circumstances, happy or sad, no matter how easy or difficult, and most of all, I promise to always encourage and support your dreams and your passions. Your selflessness, your sensitive nature, your humor, your steadfastness in who you are and what you stand for are all reasons that I love you to the deepest depth of my soul. And there's nothing more that I want to say to you right now than to tell you that you complete me. But the truth is, in Christ, I've already been made complete. But what I do know with 100% certainty is that his death on the cross was the biggest public display of affection there ever was and ever will be. And I know that he loved me enough to give me you. And Brett, today in front of God and family and our friends, I vow to you my very last breath.